God provides, so why do I worry about my life? When you come to my rescue a thousand times, every other voice it is a lie. God provides, God provides in ways I can't explain and can't deny. The little that I have, He multiplies. Just when I feel He won't show up on time, God provides. He'll come through when the clouds of doubt rain down on you and test everything you thought you knew. Now you finally see what God can do for you. So tonight, close your eyes, there's no more need to fight. Watch God provide. God provides. It's hard to say when there's no food to eat, or what you see feels all that life will be. And will this be another year of misery for me? God provides.
Yeah.
He will
provide.
Before your eyes. Oh, He will. He will.
So tonight,
close your eyes. There's no more need to fight.
Where I've never been before, a place I've never seen before. When I come to the end of myself, Father, carry me. Father, carry me. When I come to the end of myself, Father, carry me. Father, carry me.
Cover us.
carry me over.
Lead me over.
Carry 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 me
over.
When I come to the end of myself,
I wanna be where you are. I wanna be where you are, dwelling in your presence, sitting at the table, surrounded by your glory,
in your presence.
In your presence.
Hallelujah.
That's where I always want to be.
Yes, yes.
I just want to be with you.
Jesus said, I am the resurrection and the life. He that believeth in me, though he were dead, yet shall he live. And whosoever liveth and believeth in me shall never die. I know that my Redeemer liveth, and that he shall stand at the latter day upon the earth. And I shall see God, whom I shall see for myself, and mine eyes shall behold, and not another. We brought nothing into this world, and it is certain we can carry nothing out. The Lord gave, the Lord hath taken away. Blessed be the name of the Lord. We're here this morning to pay our last respect to Mr. Jeremiah Codner. Bless the name of the Lord. Let me first of all extend sincere condolences to his family, his friends, the community that has gathered here today. Praise the name of the Lord to say goodbye to this man. Praise God. Let's bow our heads in prayer at this time. Praise the name of the Lord. Father, we thank you for your blessings. We thank you, Lord, for what you have done. You have been good to us. Lord God Almighty, you have given us life, and every single person standing here today can testify that you have given unto us that which you have promised, which is life and an opportunity to come to know you as their personal Savior. We ask you, Lord Jesus, that as we proceed this afternoon in this activity, Lord God Almighty, that there'll be order, that Lord God Almighty, somebody will come to recognize that you're God and that you're in control. Praise the name of the Lord, and that you're to be worshipped. We pray right now, Lord Jesus, for comfort of the family of the bereaved, the friends of the bereaved, the community members, Lord God Almighty. We ask now, Lord, that you comfort them. Wipe away the tears, Lord Jesus, and remind them, O God Almighty, of the good times that they have shared together. We ask now, Lord Jesus, these mercies in Jesus' name. Praise God. Remain standing, turn in your program. Praise the name of the Lord to the opening hymn. Praise God. Great is thy faithfulness, O God my Father. There is no shadow of turning with thee. Thou changest not. Thy compassion, they fail not. As thou art been, and thou forever will be. Praise the name of the Lord.
Great is thy
Oh, not have me,
of the Lord. His faithfulness is beyond all measure. Great is thy faithfulness. Praise the name of the Lord. He is committed to every promise that he has made unto us. And today we need to rest assured that he is with us. Praise the name of the Lord. You may be seated. Praise God. Praise God. As we call the various items, praise the name of the Lord. We want you to come quickly as soon as one person is finished. Then we expect the next person to take the mic quickly, and you will use the mic on that level. Praise the name of the Lord. We're going to be having the first lesson taken from the book of Job, chapter 14, 1 to 10. And the first lesson will be read to us by Tamika Douglas and Annalise Harris. We're inviting Tamika Douglas and Alicia Harris to come with the first lesson. And they're going to be followed by tributes from Jennifer Thompson, Sylvia Shaw, and Rosalie Vincent. You will come in that order.
Good morning. The scripture reading is taken from Job 14. Man that is born of a woman is of few days and full of trouble. He cometh forth like a flower and is cut down. He fleeth also as a shadow and continueth not. And dost thou open thine eyes upon such a one and bringest me into judgment with thee? Who can bring a clean thing out of an unclean thing? Not one. Seeing his days are determined, the number of his months are within thee, thou hast appointed his bonds that he cannot pass. Turn from him that he may rest, till he shall accomplish as an hireling his day. For there is hope of a tree, if it be cut down, that it will sprout again, and that the tender branch thereof will not cease. Though the root thereof wax old in the earth, and the stalk thereof die in the ground, yet through the scent of water it will bud, and bring forth boughs like a plant. But man dieth, and wasteth away. Yea, man giveth up the ghost, and where is he? As the waters fail from the sea, and the flood decayeth and dryeth up. Here endeth a portion of God's holy words.
Is Jennifer Thompson here? We're going to be calling once. Sylvia Shaw. Sylvia Shaw. Rosalie Vincent. All right, Jennifer Thompson, you're going to have to wait until Sylvia Shaw is finished. So sit close by. Is Rosalie Vincent here?
Bless the Lord. Bless the Lord again. His blood will carry me all the way. Lord, take me down to the place where I found. Oh, His blood will carry me.
And through my life.
Hallelujah. I will sing. Can we lift our hands and just glorify him? I will sing of the goodness of God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. When I think of the goodness of Jesus and all he has done for me, talking about here today, the goodness of Jesus. Bless the name of the Lord. Praise God. Praise God. Let me take the opportunity to extend greetings to Minister McLeod. Praise God. Minister Golden. Bless the name of the Lord. And I think I forget, I did not in my opening statement extend greetings to every single person in the house. I want to greet you in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. And before we go further, praise God, I'm going to ask Minister McLeod, praise God, First Lady of this church, to come and greet us.
Praise the Lord, everybody. Praise the Lord, everybody. Praise God. This afternoon, I just want to greet the bereaved family and convey condolence on behalf of this pastor of this church and the saints of this church. We want to say condolence to the bereaved family, and we want to let you know that we will be praying your strength, because I'm telling you that loss of a loved one is not an easy thing. Not easy. My aunt is waiting to be buried too. And I know it's not easy. But the God that we serve continually, he is able to give us the strength to cope in the time of bereavement. And so I say to you this afternoon, your loved one is gone, but at all times they left a legacy that we, the remaining ones, have to treasure. And so we need to ensure that we cherish the memories of our loved ones. They may be dead, but we should have them living on in our memory and in our thoughts. The legacy that they left us, we need to cherish it and we need to carry on. I'm saying to us, that each of us, when we are born, there's two things we are sure of: birth and death. But I'm saying to us, we have been given time, and time is the currency that we have right now. And so we need to ensure that we use this currency and use it wisely. He did live his life, and he has lived a long time. He has used his currency. But it is between him and his maker. How did he use it? Praise God. And so I'm saying to somebody this afternoon, use your time wisely. Use it wisely. Because someday it is going to be required of you to give an account of how you spend this currency called time. God bless you. In Jesus' name.
God, thank you, Minister McLeod. Bless the name of the Lord. Is Beverly Campbell, hope I got the name right, is Beverly Campbell here? We're going to invite her to come at this time, and she's going to be doing an item. Bless the name of the Lord. Soon as she's through, we're going to be asking Tamisha McLean and Sonique Jack. You will come with the reading of the second lesson.
Good afternoon, everyone. It's praise the Lord.
Let's praise the Lord. Hallelujah. This is a song for the family.
Is your burden heavy as you bear it all alone? Does the road you travel harbor danger yet unknown? Are you growing weary in the struggle of it all? Jesus will help you when on his name you call. He's always there, here in every path, faithful and true. Walking by your side, in his love you hide all the day through. When you get discouraged, just remember what to do. Reach out to Jesus, he's reaching out to you. He's always there,
afternoon. Ecclesiastes 3 verse 1 to 14. To everything there is a season and a time to every purpose under the heaven. a time to burn, a time to die, a time to plant and a time to pluck up that which is planted, a time to kill, a time to heal, a time to break down and a time to build up, a time to weep and a time to laugh, a time to mourn and a time to dance, a time to cast away stones and a time to gather stones together, a time to embrace and a time to refrain from embracing, a time to get, a time to lose, a time to keep and a time to catch away, cast away,
a time to rend, a time to sow, a time to keep silent and a time to speak, a time to love and a time of hate, a time of war and a time of peace. What profit hath he that worketh in that wherein he laboreth? I have seen the travail that God hath given to the sons of men to be exercised in it. He hath made everything beautiful in his time. Also he hath set the world in their hearts so that no man can find out the work that God maketh from the beginning to the end. I know that there is no good in them but for a man to rejoice and to do good in his life, and also that every man should eat and drink and enjoy the good of all his labor. It is the gift of God. Here endeth a portion of God's holy word.
Thanks be to God.
Praise the name of the Lord. A time to be born, a time to die. Praise God. And might I add this to it, a time to give your life to the Lord. A time to give your life to the Lord. Praise God. We're going to be in the interim, the remembrance. Is it ready? You're showing it from there. All right. So we're going to take a selection and give you the opportunity to properly queue up and ready with it. Amen? Praise God. So we're going to invite Sister Morrison. We're inviting Sister Morrison to come at this time, and she's going to be doing an item. And then as soon as she's through, I'm going to ask you to direct your attention to the screen on this side, where you will see the representation of Mr. Condor over the years. Amen? Praise God. God bless you.
There is hope in the Lord.
That's it.
There is hope in King Jesus.
Yes.
There is hope in God. There is hope. There is hope in the Lord. There is hope. Jesus, hope in God. There is hope. There is hope in the Lord. There is hope in King Jesus. Oh, there is hope in God. There is hope. Hallelujah, hallelujah. There is hope in the Lord.
Thanks. Jesus, praise the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. Praise God. I've done quite a few funerals in my years in the ministry. And every time I get to do a funeral, not of a young person who was gunned down or killed by the knife or some other form, It gives me a different feeling. It gives me a different feeling. Too many of our young persons or young men or young women are losing their lives through other means. But Mr. Jeremiah lived a full life. He got all of 70 years and 10, plus a little bit more. Amen? We don't know if we're going to be that blessed. So it therefore means that we are to make our calling and our election sure at this time. Amen? Praise God. We're going to invite a few individuals from the church to come. We want to collect an offering. It's now offering time. This is where we all get an opportunity to participate in the service if we have not been participating otherwise. I'd like to ask you just to look around. Look around at what you're seeing happening. And you notice that if you were here, if you're here a couple of months ago, you would not have seen the place tiled. You would have seen the provision made for carpet to be laid at the front here. And the carpet is at the back. It means that some persons have been making great sacrifice to accomplish these things. And so we're going to ask you to partner with us as we seek to lift an offering towards the further or towards the completion of this assembly. Now, in November of this year, which is just a few weeks away, in November, and November, what is it, Reverend? November, write it down. November 13th. November 13th, we're going to be having the dedication of this building. We're inviting everybody that is here to be back on that day. But we're also taking the opportunity to invite you to worship with us tomorrow right here in church. Amen? Amen? Praise God. May I invite us all to stand at this time? Bless the name of the Lord. Let's stand everywhere. Praise God, praise God, praise God. We're going to lift an offering, and I'm inviting everyone to stand for the blessing of the offering. Praise the name of the Lord. Praise God. Let's bow our heads in prayer. God, we thank you for your people. We thank you, Lord Jesus, that you have blessed us abundantly. And by blessing us, Lord Jesus, you have commanded us that you have blessed us so we can bless others. We're here to lift an offering, Lord Jesus, for the furtherance of the kingdom, the development of the ministry here. And so we ask you now, Lord Jesus, that you touch the hearts of every individual present, and that God Almighty, they will give as unto the Lord. Bless now, we ask, and bless the offering of your people in Jesus' name. We're singing, you remain standing if you can. We're turning to a program, and we're singing the officiator song, or the offering song, praise the name of the Lord, in that great triumphant morning. Praise God.
The morning when,
in that great triumphant morning, when we hear the bridegroom cry, and the dead in Christ shall rise, we'll be changed to life immortal.
Thank you.
Praise the name of the Lord. What a day that will be. Praise God when the Lord Jesus steps out and calls his children home. Bless the name of the Lord. I'm looking forward to that day. The question is, are you looking forward to that day? I trust that before we leave here this afternoon, we will be able to say we're all looking forward to that day. Amen. Praise God. We're going to be having the eulogy read to us by Mrs. Charmaine Cherise, a community representative.
Before I read the eulogy, I just want to say something on behalf of Mr. Jeremiah Codner. To our moderator, officiating minister, host Bishop MacLeod, Mrs. MacLeod, Minister Golden, Minister Bernard, our Pastor Tyson, we just want to, family members, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, to our musician, a pleasant morning to you all. A pleasant morning to you all. And on behalf of my church, in which I'm a part of, the Good Hope Baptist Church, and my own family, want to convey our deepest condolences to the family of Jeremiah Codner, otherwise called Byman. I would address him, Mars Byman. He was my neighbor, and so he was a good neighbor. I can recall some years ago, I had a guinea tree on my property, on our property, and Uncle Clive would have wanted to hew it down. And Mars Byman would strongly say to him, don't cut it down, don't cut down the guinea tree. And today, even as I speak, it was 2 days ago, yes, his family member from Madras, one of his cousins, came over, wanted guinea. I said, go on the tree, man, and see what you can find. And he got some guinea. I'm saying this to say that I thank God for Mars Byman not to let that tree hewn down, because today we can eat from that guinea tree. And so he left and went over to Spicy Hill, and then back at Prospect to be my neighbor. When he returned, he could not walk. He had was to be lifted from the car to get into his daughter's home, Miss Dion. And so I would say to her, I'm going to give him a visit. It so happened that on the third Sunday, leaving my own communion, after my communion service, I purposely saved 2 emblems to give him communion, for us to have communion together. I left church, go straight over to his daughter's house, and I called him, we point him in the word and remind him of his faith. He was a member of the Spicefield New Testament Church of God, and so I remind him of his faith, and I asked him to pray a confess prayer to God, because we are going to have communion together. We did have communion together, and we did pray, and tears just came down his face of the joy, knowing that, as Sister Morris sung, there is hope. There is hope in King Jesus. There is hope in the Lord. And I would pause in a short while to say, Miss Dion, in which I addressed her, showed good hospitality to her father. When he could not walk, she'd take care of him. And I want the church to put your hands together for Miss Dion Codner. For when her father could not walk, she spend quality time to make sure he gets some good attention. I live to see Mr. Moss Byman walk again and decided to return to Spicy Hill. His health deteriorated, and so be it. But I want to really give thanks to see that he could make that decision that he's going to strengthen his life, spiritual life with the Lord. And so I hope to meet him there. May his soul rest in peace and light perpetual shine on his way. I thank you. Today, we gather to celebrate the life of Jeremiah Codner, better known as Jerry or Byman. It is with heavy heart that we bid farewell to a loving father, grandfather, great-grandfather, uncle, brother, cousin, and friend, Jeremiah Codner, born to parents Casita Bars in the parish of St. Anne. While growing up, Byman used to play the big brother role with his siblings. If they were out of line, he would make sure he put them in place with some good beating, especially his little brothers. He lived in Madras for more than half his life, where he started farming at a young age, between the age of 27 and 28. Byman met a woman called Lovita Johnson, also known as Lucky. They fell in love with each other while they had two beautiful daughters, Diane and Valerie. Sadly, she passed away when the two girls were only 9 and 7 years old. A few years after Lucky's death, Byman met a woman called Kathleen. While they were together, he was given the opportunity to go to Canada. He was given the opportunity to go to Canada on the farm work program. But before going, he found out about his third child, Mando. But things did not work out for him, as Kathleen, while he was traveling, 1 year, when he returned home, he met Beverly Clark, also known as Roxy. They met in a little village called Broadleaf in Barnstaple, where they became friends. One evening, Byman was going home from his farm on his donkey, and he stopped at Roxy's mother's home. But before he left the house, he turned to Roxy's mother and said, "Miss daughter, me love your daughter, Roxy, and I am a serious man." She answered him and said, "How were you saying? It look like you have enough money to pay for me black girl." They both laughed. From there on, they fell in love. In 1990, she then moved in together with him in Brompton, Madras. After a while, Byman was having financial troubles due to insufficient work in the community. It was then they both decided to move to Vale Royal in Trelawney for a better life in 1992. He started working with Long Pond Estate as a sugarcane farmer and started planting his own crops on his farm. While living in Vale Royal, Roxy gave birth to Chanel, Byman's fourth child. Their love did not end there. She then gave birth to his fifth child, Akeem. who Byman called Briggy, our boy. They lived together in Trelawney for 8 years before the union ended. He worked with Long Pond for over a decade, and then he stopped cutting cane and then started working as a ranger for the same company. He later moved from Vale Royal to Samuel Prospect with his son Briggy, where he continued farming and raising animals. In 2014, Byman moved to Spice Hill to live, where he continued his passion for farming and started working in Silver Sand as a maintenance personnel. Byman had high blood pressure from a young age, but due to aging and a lot of physical labor, he started having heart problems. Due to his illnesses and COVID-19, he had to discontinue all physical labor, and that put a toll on his heart. So he stopped working in Silver Sand in 2019. Byman is a good person, a God-fearing man. When he was healthy, he would attend the Church of God in his community, where he would put on his Sunday best and have his Bible in his hand. One thing about Byman, he loved to cook. And when the kids were young, he would cook and put a lot of food on their plates, to the point where the kids would hide and throw some away. For him, farming was a passion and a way of life. He loved raising animals and planting yam and other ground provisions. No matter how hot or rainy the day was, you would see him heading to his ground to attend to his prized possessions. Byman was a stubborn man. Despite the warning from doctors and his family, he would not give up the farming. In 2019, when he first got ill and was told to rest, he refused, and his words were, "Who will take care of me grown? Of me animal them?" His health started to get worse. That's when he started his hospital visits, and his children start to take care of him. As time goes by, Byman's illnesses really got serious to the point where his heart problems caused him to have a stroke, where he was hospitalized on the 12th of July, 2023. While he was admitted in the hospital, he was visited by family and friends who prayed with him and ensured him that he was well taken care of. Unfortunately, he was tired of fighting his sickness, and he let go on the 28th of July, 2023, at around 9 p.m. He left in mourning 5 children, Dion, Valerie, Mando, Chanel, and Briggy, 10 grandchildren, 8 great-grandchildren, 9 sisters, and 6 brothers, nieces, nephews, other relatives, and friends. As we lay dear Jeremiah to rest, I leave with this: for none of us lives to himself, and none of us dies to himself. For if we live, we live to the Lord. And if we die, we die to the Lord. So then, whether we live or whether we die, we are the Lord's. May his soul rest in peace, and light perpetual shine on his way. I thank you.
Thank you very much, Mrs. Charmaine. Praise the name of the Lord. Praise God. Before we're getting set for the word, and it's so important that I encourage you not to move, but to ensure that you get the word today. But we're going to invite to come with an item Tamisha McLean and Renee Graham, so granddaughter and friend. Tamisha McLean and Renee Graham, will you come? We're going once. Another selection. That after she's through, the man of God, anointed by God, full of the Holy Ghost, speaking the word as the Lord lays it on his heart. Minister Golden is going to come after that to preach the word of the Lord to us. Sister Brittany Camber is going to minister to us in song, and then the ministering of the word will follow.
Let's bless the Lord, everybody. Let's praise the Lord, everybody. Let's bless the Lord one more time. Hallelujah. If you ever feeling down, like you have nowhere to go, if you feeling like a knocker, as your problems overflow, just remember there is someone, and all it takes is for you to know is that God is the answer, and God answers first. Mountain and sea, and the sea.
Thing for certain, God answers prayer. Somebody praise him. Somebody praise him. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. 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 Glory to God, one thing for certain, God answers prayer. Praise God. Greetings to our moderator today. Greetings to First Lady, our bishop in his absence. Our condolences to the grieving family. And greetings to friends and neighbors. Glory to God Almighty. One thing for certain, God answer prayer. And I'll only talk to you for a few minutes as the time is going, praise God. But I'll talk to you today from Romans 6. Praise God, and I read, praise God, from 21. And it reads us, what fruit have he then? In those things whereof ye are now ashamed. For the end of those things is death. But now being made free from sin and become servant to God, ye have your fruit unto holiness and the end everlasting life. For the wages of sin is death. But the gift of God is eternal life through Jesus Christ, our Lord. This train I'm riding, this sail believing, to a place soul shall never die, and my pilot will be Jesus, to the mountain way up in the sky. We'll be right back. Hallelujah, 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 praise God, hallelujah. Don't be grieving, praise God, because I am leaving. Don't you cry when I say goodbye. There'll be no weeping where I'm going to the mountain will be in the sky. Hallelujah. Can I say it again? Don't be grieving because I'm leaving. Don't you cry when I say goodbye. Don't come searching. Can't find me. Glory to God. The writer says, the wages of sin is death, but the gift of God is eternal life. Not just eternal life. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Every single man and woman, the long time past 18 and start to work, expect a salary. And if the boss appear them a serious problem, so every man deserve and expect a pay. Hallelujah. Glory to God. The wages of sin is that who you're working for, who is going to pay you. Glory to God. If you're working with Sanders, I can't pay you. Your paycheck make up a Sanders. Glory to God Almighty. Some people, they are saying they love God, but yet still they are wearing the wrong clothing. Some people say they love KFC, but yet never go to Burger King. Can't eat burger and love KFC. If you love God, serve Him. If you love God, serve Him. The payment for sin is death.
somebody give from God is eternal life. Man and woman, boys and girls, who you working for? Some people says they are God fearing. Some other man say, I love God. Some people say, I go to church. But there's a criteria to work for Jesus, God Almighty. There is a requirement that Jesus required for men. If you want to work for God, it is not a room for rent. Supply within. This day you jump out, and tomorrow you jump in. It is a requirement. Some of us jump in when we have problem. Some of us jump in when it's not going well. So we jump in and take a ride on the bus. But as soon as you reach a bus stop where the road gets smooth, you jump off. But the wages of sin is death. Who are you working for? Who will pay you? You can't work as Sanders and they go hired to pay a bill. Working for Jesus, declare righteousness, declare holiness. But when you're working for the devil, it don't require any criteria. Working for the devil, you do anything and he's satisfied. But when it comes to God, you must live holy. You must walk holy. You must baptize. You must pray and seek God. Somebody says, God not loving people so much and kill them and burn them up. But you have it wrong. Even the man that created a robot, we know they might create them now, they call it AI. Expect the robot to obey him. And he have an expectation of the robot system. And anytime he go against his rule, he's going to dismantle it and destroy it. Because it's not obeying him. Hallelujah. But the thing, the difference with the robot, they don't have a choice. They have to do what their master says and what they're programmed to do. When it comes to Jesus, it is completely different. He creates his people and give his people a choice whether you want to serve him or not. Because he knows that there's a day coming. Pay day they come. Somebody says when you're dead, it is over. But Carly said when you're dead, you're upon vacation. Or you retire from this life. But pay day they come. You don't hear me say? Pay day they come. You're going to rest to meet your Savior. What will your pay be like? Let me talk to the preacher a little bit. Preacher, what will your pay be like? Does that mean saying I won't say in the hell too? I'll be going dead. God, that's all some already eat, you know. You're going dead and you're going dead. What are we going dead? But there is a pay day. And every single man of you will stand up before God to give account for your sin. If man of judgment all, how about Jesus? If man they carry you go to court and they judge you, how about Jamaica? You think that God is make you feel live? Anyhow, lie down and dead and we perish and we gone. Eh? After we not go. A cow, goat, and dog, and they jack down and dead and gone and perish. If you notice, nobody not make you lie down the road and see the hit and you're gone. Nobody not do that. They make sure so they make one coffee and give a smooth send off. And then cry for you and say you're gone too soon. But even me crying now, there is a day coming where you have to stand up before God and you must give account for your work. Man, woman, boy, girl, you must give account for your work. What work you're doing? Who hire you? Master Jerry gone. You know what I'm saying? Him done for him job already. All of him that we have put up here did. And nobody can change the check but Jesus. God Almighty. Nobody can write to home about Jesus. This man resume already right. You could have come out with your eulogy some more. And pretty it up some more. This a eulogy I've done right long time. And we are here writing our own eulogy. Some of us pretty it up. We don't write what we know. But because we want something good when we come to church, we put on something in it. Now talk about my Jeremy, I don't know nothing about him. But we don't know him. And I can't talk about him again. He's done writing thing already. But I am here to encourage you that the PMN day is coming. Grandchildren, PMN day they come. Preach among them, PMN day they come. Who are you working for? What will be your salary? Some of us don't do nothing but we want to pay. Boy boss work and hide all day. But when weekend come, we got a bank machine. Not sure, put up your hand. Can you expect to get your pay? Can you name the funny book? But you don't do no work. Not true. And if you don't pay, you say you go out work all week. And you don't see nothing coming in your and you go call after seeing them. And call HR. Not true. And call your manager and call your supervisor. I mean, you see no pay. But when it comes to Jesus Christ, Master, no call nobody. No call nobody. Because he know your work. He know your stand. He know the life you live. Goalie boy, he know for your life too. See me preach to myself. Brother Goalie, live right. Pay the end of come. Be like, oh, you look good, you look pretty now. But pay the here they come. All right, preach. You preach, I tell somebody, say, look good. Yes, you look good. But pay the here, he's coming. You look can't change it. You good looking clothes can't change it. Your shape can't change it. Your money can't change it. Not even your pump. Now your grandpa can't change it. You the work for yourself. Somehow we can't pay where we are at this life, either. Because we have money. And somehow we know somebody. You know, you hear me say? How we can't go through. But when it comes to Jesus, God Almighty, and my father stand up at your gate. My father did it. My father stand up for himself. Lord God Almighty, in your Alexander Golden. He must be stand up before God. And if you run no good, he won't pay. You don't hear me? Jeremiah. I don't do any work. But the wages of sin is death. Man, the wages of sin is death. But the gift of God. Is eternal life. And which one of them we want? Which one of them we want? Some of us live with only 3 score and 10 already. And some of us go in there. And who you the work for? Some of us are going to love Satan. But how can you not love Emmanuel Ingrid? I love somebody else, I still say, I am your love. If you love a man, serve him. You can't say you love a man out the road. And I live with it this morning. I'll hear it tell. Not true. God help mighty man. And so some of us say, we don't love Satan, but yet we don't dance with him. We don't love him, but yet still we don't talk with him. We don't entertain him. The payment for sin is death. And Satan go pay too. You don't know. He go pay too, you know. Me say go pay. And in a little company. But you have a choice. God could make us like robot. That we have no choice. Me say God could make me like robot that we walk on the road. And I have no choice but serving him. But because he loves us with an everlasting love, he gave us a choice. Whether you want to serve me or not, be the kill choice. Can you know what's ever pay for you? But he got a mercy today. God be our founding judge later. What will your answer be? And I encourage in the heart. Because the one thing we know for sure, that tomorrow somebody has gone dead. Aye, preacher. Yeah, you ever say? One thing for sure, somebody else going on the casting. Who gonna pay you? The wages of sin is death. Me say the wages of sin is death. What kind of life you done live? I've been around with the man that I brought in the yard. Me say what kind of life we done live? Are we serving God or the devil? One or the other? Can't serve two masters. You don't hear me say? Can't serve two masters, must one. Can't dance with Satan. And I say, I love God. If you love God, dance with God, no man. If you love God, talk to him. All right, can I have a few over now? I say I'm going to preach you in a few minutes. But Lord God Almighty, I want to beg you today that you get your soul saved. Dance go over, you hear? It dance go over. You don't hear me? Me used to dance, see, you know? But me said, it dance! It's going to hover. The selector is going to stop playing. The bingo game is going to stop. You know, you hear me say, the boyfriend go leave. And if you're not here, you and the boyfriend go turn up before God. You know, you hear me say, you and the boyfriend go stand up before God. And if you're dead before him, you go and get the next girl. Your soul is yours. Your soul is yours. Make the right choice. The girlfriend sweet and the boyfriend sweet. You know, you ever say, the word of this is sweet, you know. But one day they come. One day they come. Lord God Almighty. Sometimes you feel some pain, you can't bother with the boyfriend. Talk to me, no man, not true. Sometimes you have some problem, you don't want the girlfriend, because you can't fix it. And you're not comfortable, not true. Lord God Almighty, you only they call upon God. God help me, God help me. Talk to me, no man, well, we are Jamaican and we know. We they call upon God, God help me. But yet still, when things are still smooth, you don't want God. You want boyfriend. PNA they come. Mama, papa, PNA they come. Pretty girl and handsome man, PNA they come. The wages of sin is that. city girl. Here they come. God Almighty. There was this girl. Praise God. Conviction take her. She gets saved. But she love him on so much that when she gets saved, they say, let us have the last dance. Last dance. Jump on bike. Gonna party. Cause she want the last dance with honey. But Lord Jesus Christ, the bike crash and beauty dead. Man come back right in a funeral. Man gets healed. Accept Jesus as his personal savior. But my lady won't want the last dance. Can you hear me say? Some of us go dance the last dance. All right, make a preacher talk. The wages of sin is death. But the gift of God is eternal life. My brothers and sisters, mama, you don't understand me, not Jamaican. Say, if me say mama, you don't understand how me talk. Make I tell you something. Every single thing, what we do now, even the preacher, yeah, if you don't live right, go stop. Man, you say you look handsome now because you're young. One day a wrinkle will come into your face. You know what I'm saying? And you're going to lose the beauty that all I ladies them see. You know what I mean? And ladies, even the dimples, you know what I mean? You're going to lose it because he is the dog. But when you lose it, Jesus still loves you. I don't know where society gone now. Because if man wants to still feel young, I just feel all of it. Because if man wants to still feel young, he gets a 16-year-old. Hallelujah! Watch your man, I feel all of it, something up there preacher. But me, I tell you the truth. Because if man wants to feel young, he gets a 16-year-old. Vice versa, the woman won't feel it. Say, get the young boy. Hey. But the day they come, where you're going to stand before your God. You're going to stand up before God, you know. Oh, look on the pretty. And God make you know. Look so good. I don't know, I serve him. Not me, so I don't know, I serve him. So I don't know. Now serve God. And that's how I make with him. To serve him. Above everything else, it is important that you seek a place for your soul to live. A testimony I'm coming out of my mind, I'm going to testify. Because they testify too much, but most people know it. You hear me say? But you don't know it. Eh? One man. And I'm calling him. This man living in the community, drunk every time. Drunk. But he come to church on Sunday night. And sit down on the back. It's when the offering time come, in rocking way, that's why they don't have a damn church. In rocking way from a pulpit, I'm paying offering. You know, hear me? He pay offering come, but he never gets saved. One day, I go to the hospital, and he said, Pastor, I look around and I say, are you? He said, yes. He said, Pastor, me hear a word, but it's too late. And I say it. He said, Pastor, me hear the word, but it's too late. I say, what are you doing? Whenever asthma, but he can't breathe so good again. And doctor tell him to go on home. In backpack. Doctor send him home. Because doctor can't help him no more. You don't hear me? No time after. When he reach home. Dead. But one time he went young. And he made a come to church. And that's why I know me. He's a pastor. I heard the word. But it's too late. Look how we look pretty at today. Look on ourselves. Look on the whole of it. We don't look good. Eh? You may be pretty down, me still look good, don't you? I ask you. I hold on me to look on you. You hold on pretty. But one day, you see that something else? Even man will carry come here. One day, fifth day they come, somebody else will carry him. But what will your answer be? What will your answer be? Boss, where your answer go be? Every single man here have the answer to them boss at workplace. Any of you know why boss here have the answer? So what about Jesus? Eh? What about Jesus? As we take Jesus above see and go to. Eh? And that's why we take Jesus sign up. So, you can't do anything, Angela. Alright, preacher, don't preach. You have to bury this man. We have a can't go to my cemetery. The wages of sin is death, but the gift of God is eternal life through Jesus Christ. What will your answer be? What will your answer be? If you want to get saved, we're available to baptize in Jesus' name. If you're not close to baptize, we will find close. Carry good on and see baptizing in Jesus' name. You speak in tongues and on your way to glory, living a holy life. It is open for you to get saved. Man, woman, boy, and girl, salvation is for you. Somebody say, hell don't make for dogs, but it did not make for you to go there. It's for the devil and his angel. But if you disobedient and join the devil's side, you will help him down there. But one thing, life is guaranteed in Jesus Christ. God bless you in Jesus' name.
Hallelujah. Oh God, what will your answer be? Rev, this is a move of God. Hallelujah. If you are here and you hear the words, the Bible says, harden not your heart. Oh, bless the name of the Lord. Because for sure, the wages of sin is death, but the gift of God is eternal life. Can we lift our hands and thank him? We're still in the land of the living. We're still at the place where decisions are made. Bless the name of the Lord. Before we leave here to do the interment, we want to pray for the family. Oh, bless the name of the Lord of Mr. Jeremiah. We're inviting the family members, and I hope. You know, brethren, friends, things and times have changed. I went to a funeral one day, and I had to preach the first item on the program. I had to preach the message, because if I didn't preach the message, as soon as everybody get to do what they are supposed to do,
church is empty. And we're noticing that these days. As soon as everybody gets to do what they are doing, church is empty. We're going to have to change the program around, Reverend. Praise God. Hallelujah. Members of the family, the bereaved family, we want to present you to the Lord. We're going to invite other members of the congregation to stand. Members of the family, we want you to remain seated. And I would to God that if there are some persons on the outside that are members of the family, that if it is possible, you can come inside. We have enough space inside here. We don't charge you a tax for sitting inside here. So if you're a family member, we invite you to come on the inside. We want to pray for you. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah.
His voice makes the difference. When he speaks, he releases my trouble. It's the only voice I hear that makes the difference.
Minister McLeod, come again and pray for the family members of Mr. Jeremiah.
Oh Lord,
continue to sing that chorus. His voice makes a difference.
strength is made perfect when we're weak. When the road is long and heavy, when it's dark and darkened, see clearly, I will lift my eyes to thy hills, from whence my help cometh. My help comes from you. Lead me, oh, lead me, oh, lead me to where I've never been before, a place I've never seen. When I come to the end of myself, Father, carry me. Father, carry me. When I come to the end of myself, Father, carry me.
Father, carry me, yeah.
right,
we're going to ask the assistant to load a casket, please.
They won't need it, don't drop it.
Win. Where does it?
Come.
Take that time, go on the way.
Bring it, and I'm going to go.
Sorry.
Oh boy, Jerry Gondon, man.
Yeah.
Okay, cool.
And for those who are nearby and you can get some petals in your hand, please do so.
Rum.
We're Rum. About to commit the body of Mr. Jeremiah Codner. For as much as it had pleased Almighty God in His wise providence to take out of this world unto Himself the soul of our departed brother, for some father, for some grandfather, for some great grandfather, for some uncle, great uncle, for some friends, our dear beloved friend Jeremiah Codner would therefore commit his body to the ground, earth to earth, ashes to ashes, dust to dust. I heard a voice from heaven saying unto me, write, blessed are the dead which died in the Lord. From henceforth, he said, the spirit that may rest from their labor and their works to follow them. I know that my Redeemer liveth and shall stand at the latter day upon the earth. And though after my skin were destroyed this body, yet in my flesh I shall see God, whom I shall see for myself, and mine eyes shall be whole, not another. Remember, we brought nothing into this world, and it is certain we carry nothing out. The Lord give it, and the Lord take it. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Brethren, let's bow our heads in prayer. Father, we thank you for your blessings. We thank you for the life of our friend or brother, father, grandfather. We thank you for that which he has contributed to this society. Lord God Almighty, as he now moves on to await eternity, we ask Lord Jesus that the memory, the good examples that he set for all of us who have come in contact with him, that good example, those good examples will resonate in our hearts, and that will continue, he'll continue to live on with us. We pray now, Lord Jesus, that you will guide us. Let everything that is going to be done this afternoon be done decently and in order. And all the glory belongs to you, in Jesus' name. Amen. We're turning to the program. There are some choruses that are there that we're going to be singing while the workmen get ready to cover. Praise the name of the Lord.
Here you go, get us ready.
God is my keeper. God is my keeper. God is my keeper.
Shut up! lift up the name of Jesus. For the name of Jesus lifted me.
Wherever I am,
I'll praise him whenever I can. I'll praise him for his love surrounds me like the sea. I'll praise the name of Jesus. I lift up the name of Jesus. For the name of Jesus
wherever I am,
wherever I am, I praise him whenever I can.
Yes, I praise him
for his love surrounds me like the sea.
Yes,
I praise the name of Jesus. I lift up the name of Jesus. For the name of Jesus,
I praise the name.
I praise the name of Jesus. I lift up the name of Jesus. For the name of Jesus lifted me.
Hallelujah!
We worship the King of Kings. We magnify the Lord of Lords.